welcome to Lauren's Travels. I am experiencing some of my favorite places today because it's been a while. I've been in my apartment quite a bit. So I am stopping first at Craft and Common and getting some pumpkin spice coffee. So let me show you Craft and Common a little bit. The parking for Craft and Common's a little awkward. You could either park behind the building or right down there where those other cars are. That's where I parked. And I know that there is a axe throwing place right next door. But yeah, I have been to Craft and Common several times and they do have seasonal drinks. So this pumpkin spice one is on that seasonal list. Something else that's new is they started serving breakfast and lunch. They have some little finger foods here. And there's a doggy. They sell things here, like they have their own t-shirts, and you can also get some really cute cards here. I like this one a lot. And this is the axe throwing place that's right next door. Really want to do this one day. I saw Christina over at Burger With Everything did one. So yeah, I gotta try my hand at this one day. So pro tip, mornings are very busy, as like any coffee shop would be. So you can actually place your order in advance to pick up at a certain time. I placed my order last night. I believe the number to text is 33733. You can text that and then place your order for what you want and the time and day that you want to pick it up. So highly recommend doing that instead of waiting in line, because there was at least 4 people in line when I went in. Okay, I made it back to my car. And I got the pumpkin spice iced. Let's try it out. So good. Pumpkin pie in a cup, honestly. That's better than Starbucks. I gotta say it. Check out Craft and Common. I'm gonna leave their Instagram down in the description box below. It's one of my favorite coffee spots here in Orlando, and it's so cute inside, as I showed you a little bit of. And very popular. That place was full, so because of COVID, I am very like order ahead and make sure it's ready so I'm not staying in places long. So now that I have my beverage here, I'm heading on to my next favorite place, which is Orange Tree Antiques Mall. I don't know if I'm gonna buy anything because, you know, on a budget, but antique malls are one of my favorite things, especially this one because we're in Orlando area. So there's a lot of theme park merchandise that makes its way over to these antique malls. So let's go see what we can find. Already loving the things in the window here. Look at this really pretty hat box and these lamps. And then they got a cute little Halloween window here. That black cat is adorable. All right, let's see what treasures we can find inside. This whole corner is so adorable. Look at this little cat. And I'm loving the swan here. There's also some holiday specific things. I really like these presents. It's a cookie jar. And this cat is so cute. I think it's a little teapot. Those are only slightly terrifying. Same with this guy up here. I found some Nightmare Before Christmas items. They got Dr. Finkelstein right there. They got Lock, Shock, and Barrel, and even the mayor back there. Oh, we got the Wolfman. One of my favorite things about antique malls and thrift stores are like the different colored glass items. I even like this pear thing here. But I don't have a china cabinet or whatever to keep all of it in. But I like looking at it. There we go. Lots of Disney items here. These are so cute, these little ceramics. And they got the dwarfs up there too. I found this completely silver Mickey mug here. Only $8, that's really not that bad. And look at this little Mickey, so cute. They even have a little Sleeping Beauty capsule right there. Let's see how much it is. $325. It's a little out of my budget. I got some Tokyo Disney stuff here. I love the decorative plates. And this little Donald Duck boat. That's so cute, the Christmas one. Let's see see what else they have. That pin set back there is really cool from Tokyo.
Wow, someone definitely had to be a cast member working there to have this grand opening plate.
And you got a pretty large Dr. Finkelstein here from Japan. And this is a little setup of Minnie's house here. And you got more Nightmare Before Christmas collectibles.
That Jack one's interesting, but I really like that Vanellope on the Tron light cycle.
They've got very vintage school desks here and a huge vintage Mickey plush. The silver Steamboat Mickey is pretty cool. $75. There's a lot of figurines here, I'm noticing. And this section just looks pretty cool, so I'm just gonna film it all. Got a radio control BB-8. I really love the Batman art right all the way at the top. And that UFO one looks cool too.
Ooh, that's cool.
Look at this Batmobile. Bat van, bat lab, my bad. And these masks. Very little slit there for the mouth. Got some very cool things in here. Some things are even signed. Look at this Wolfman though. So cool. That lenticular one is really cool too, from 1966. They even have an old popcorn bucket here. It's $32, I already checked. Sorry for being a bit little backlit here. There we go. And I love this pumpkin that he's on top of. I really love that little monster Mount Rushmore in the back there. They just started playing Gangster's Paradise, which is weird for this antique mall setting. Oh my God, there's a Skippy. Look at this book set, pretty rare. I like the design on the side there. Got some old school toys down here. And coming up, we got some shot glasses, more decorative plates. Got some Looney Tunes sprinkled throughout. Got some old school pens. Even got some pins, even though it's kind of hard to see them in here. Tons of Disney items in this case. Ooh, look at that Wicked Witch. And you got a little more up here. This report is sponsored by Allstate. Look at these framed artworks. They're just having a nice weekend there and very fancy car that I'd like to have when I retire. But this one's amazing. And this is actually cheaper than that little Universal Monsters thing that I just saw. Look at this old school candy machine. I love the design on the side. But this design on the side is so cool. How much is it? $2.50. I also found this giant Bumble here. Looks like he's a little weather damaged, but he's pretty cute. The carousel horse with the disco ball is my aesthetic. And the skeleton here. He looks like he's seen some things. And you even have a whole shelf and cabinet of trolls. They even have a figurine of the cake castle. I know not a lot of people like the cake castle, but I do. So now that we checked out the antique mall, it's time for a snack, and I know just the place to go. So I made it over to 7 Bites. If you watch Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, they've been on it twice. And yeah, I love them. They are a bakery, but they also make regular food as well. And they serve lunch all day, so I'm gonna take some home. They've got some awesome Pulse dedicated murals out here. And you cannot miss the building because it is bright green. And it's a little loud in here, so bear with me, but I just wanted to show you some of their treats and baked goods. There are so many. And there's Guy with the sign poster back there. They even have a little Funko Pop of him. Okay, so I made it home, and I didn't really read the full description,
but these are tossed in a buffalo sauce. And then they have the nuggets here, and I got some ranch, and then there's also another sauce here. But I also got this orange blossom tea, sweet tea, and I really like it. I normally don't go for flowery teas. I usually go for fruity teas, but this is pretty good. So I'm gonna enjoy lunch here. I got a cool ghost stories book. It's like a compilation from Roald Dahl. You may remember that name from Matilda and the witches, and he had compiled all these ghost stories, so I've been reading that as well.
All right, moment of truth. Let's see how spicy these are. I don't know why I do this to myself, but I'm trying to be less of a wimp about spice. It's good and not that spicy, so yeah.
Hello. Benny.
Thanks for joining along with me today and going to some favorite places of mine. Yeah, it's trying to not do too many things outside of the apartment. I'm still trying to stay inside most of the weeks, but it can get boring and it can get tedious, and sometimes you just need to go indulge. So thanks for enjoying my day with me. My cat is extremely begging for a treat, so I should probably give him one. Something I almost forgot to mention is that they checked my temperature before going into 7 Bites, so I really appreciate that. That's pretty cool, right, Vincent? Right? He's begging. Please leave me comments down below, and I'll see you next time on Lauren's Travels. Say bye! You gonna say bye? Mom? Yeah.